Good morning all. Today we are going to see problems on Butterworth filter. Okay, right. Now let us take a problem on Butterworth filter. Now the problem given here is design a second order discrete time Butterworth filter with cutoff frequency of 1 kHz and sampling frequency of 10 power 4 samples per second by using bilinear transformation. Okay. Right here the order of the filter, they had given the order of the filter as a second order, so we can conclude n equal to 2. Okay, because they mentioned that it is 2, the cutoff frequency is actually here it is 1 kilohertz, right, and the sampling frequency is 10 power 4 samples per second. So that complete specification over here is given with respect to analog frequency, and they are asking us to design a digital filter. Okay, now to convert from analog to digital, the mapping technique to be used is mentioned here, which is the bilinear transformation. Okay, this is being started in the problem. Okay, now first let us calculate what is the digital cutoff frequency. Now what is the digital cutoff frequency? They had given n equal to 2, right? So fc equal to 1 kilohertz and fs is 10 power 4 samples per second. So the digital cutoff frequency we can calculate it as omega c equal to 2 pi fc over fs, which is 0.2 pi radians. Clear? So omega c is 0.2 pi radians. As we have found the cutoff frequency of digital filter, we'll calculate cutoff frequency of analog filter. Right? Now, we'll calculate the cutoff frequency of analog filter. See, you should first see to that the difference between this omega and the previous omega. This is your analog frequency, represents analog frequency, and that one represents your digital frequency. That is, this omega represents a digital frequency and this omega represents analog frequency. So which is equal to 2 by t tan omega c by 2. That is, you are calculating analog frequency where t will be the sampling period. Okay, now you need to find out what is the sampling period, because they had given the sampling frequency, so which is equal to 10 power 4 samples per second. So t equal to, which is 1 over fs, which is equal to 10 power minus 4 second. Do you understand? Right. Now we are finding the analog cutoff frequency 2 over 10 power minus 4 tan 0.2 pi by 2. Okay, right. So which is 6.498 into 10 power 3 radians per second. Right. Clear? Right. Now, so you need to find out after pole calculation. We have seen this pole calculation in the previous sections. So after pole calculation, the transfer function will be h of s equal to 1 over s over omega c whole square, because the order given is a second order function. So the second order transfer function is s over omega c whole square plus root 2 s over omega c plus 1. Okay, this is the transfer function for the second order filter which we have defined earlier. Clear? Right. Now when you substitute that omega c value in the transfer function, when you substitute the omega c value in the transfer function, so it is given as, now you substitute 1 over s over 6498.39. right, so here after substitution of omega c values, after substituting omega c values, we will get the transfer function. So as that is, we'll first substitute the transfer function, and according to your bilinear transformation, the s value is given as 2 over t 1 minus z inverse over 1 plus z inverse. Okay, right? So after calculating this, we will get the transfer function. The total transfer function will be this only. Okay, so you all please try to do it in the notebook, right? Okay. And next we'll see previous problem. We have seen the bilinear transformation method. Now we'll see the similar kind of a filter design, a Butterworth digital filter design using impulse invariance method. Okay, so in the impulse invariance method, actually here design of Butterworth digital filter for the following constraint. Okay, following constraint. So what is the constraint? Actually it is 0 point, that is h of e over j omega lies between 0.7072 1. Okay, right? That is, I'll tell you what is it. Actually it is a pass band and stop band frequencies only they are representing. What is the pass band frequency and what is going to be the stop band frequency? This is what they are representing, and actually it is 0.7021, right? So here we can conclude that it is a low pass filter. Okay, so 0.707 in between, your transfer function, your lies between 0.7071, so it is a low pass filter. Okay, now they had given the pass band and stop band values as it is 0.2 pi and it is 0.5 pi. Okay, so and you need to assume that t equal to 1 second. So by impulse invariant transformation method, you need to find out what is your order and you need to find out the transfer function, everything, right? Now first, in the impulse invariance transformation method, your omega equal to, that is analog frequency, is omega by t. Actually t is here given it as a 1 second, right? So omega p equal to omega p by t, which is equal to 0.2 pi by 1, which is radians per second. And similarly, this is actually your pass band frequency and your omega s is actually stop band frequency. So this is analog pass band and analog stop band frequencies. Now I told you that it is a low pass filter. So in the impulse invariance method, here the approximation values, that is 1 over 1 plus epsilon square, which is equal to 0.707. We all know that this is actually a 3 dB value, right? Right, you all know, right? Midband frequency over root 2, which is equal to a 3 dB value, so 0.707, right? And here 1 over 1 plus lambda square, square root of 1 plus lambda square. Now you find what is that approximated value of epsilon. Epsilon, after substituting 0.707 and the square on both sides, and you find out epsilon value, which is equal to 1. Similarly, 1 over root of 1 plus lambda square is 0.1. So it is your lambda value equal to 9.95. We got epsilon value and we got lambda value. Now you need to find the order of the filter. After finding your lambda value and epsilon value, so your n is greater than or equal to log of 9.95 and log of actually omega s by omega p, right? So which I got, it is greater than or equal to 2.5. so what I am doing is I am going to rounding it off to the nearest value, which the order is 3, right? Now you need to write the transfer function and you need to find out the what is omega value, that is analog cutoff frequency value also you need to find out. Okay, right. Next, the transfer function, right? Here it is the order of 3. So h of s equal to 1 over s plus 1 into s square plus s plus 1. Okay, and you find what is your omega c. Now your cutoff frequency in terms of analog is, right, pass band analog frequency over the approximated value to the power of 1 over n. So which I'll get it as a 0.2 pi. Students, it is 0.2, not it seems like a 6. No, it is actually 0.2 pi, right? Now, after substituting the values, right, values in your transfer function, and you need to resolve the transfer function, right? So you will resolve the transfer function, right? Now the poles of the function, you need to find the poles of the function, okay? That is just by applying the quadratic equation, okay? So by applying the quadratic equation, you need to resolve and you need to find out the poles of the function. Clear? Right. And next, after finding poles of the function, you take each and every value and find out by a partial fraction method. So s equal to minus 3, and you find out what is a value. Similarly, you find out what is b value, and you find out what is c value. Clear? Right. Next, got 0.0214, and your b value is 0.0113, and c value is minus 0.0113 plus 0.101j. Right. And next, now you substitute a value, b value, and c value. Now we got the transfer function as like this. So impulse invariance method, in the impulse invariance method, what you have to do is we have to find out the poles and we have to find the transfer function. In bilinear transformation method, what we have to, we should remember the order of the equation, and in case if they have specified the order, and you can directly substitute the transfer function. All the thing is, you need to first see whether it is a low pass or high pass or band pass filter. Okay, so you just see a look at your stop band and pass band frequencies, then you can find out what kind of a filter it is. Okay, so we'll solve more problems. And whenever those who are taking classes, contact classes, they will give you to solve more problems. Okay, so this is a just glance I am telling. Thank you so much.